What is up, everybody? Hope you're having a fantastic day. So today I want to talk to you about mistakes that I see common people make in the gym that is literally preventing them from being able to make lifelong progress as far as your weights, your sets, your reps, your weight, everything. So these are basically common newbie mistakes, and we're going to discuss them in detail. So the first mistake I see all the time is people focusing too much on workouts when they should be focusing on recovery. So there's no secret, you have to work out to break down muscle fiber. However, breaking down the muscle isn't the end all be all to muscle growth. In fact, 99% of growth happens while you're away from the gym. So the recovery phase, breaking down is the stimulus and rebuilding is the recovery. So technically, lifting weights doesn't build muscle at all. It's the fact that you're breaking down the muscle, and then once recovery kicks in, the recovery is what builds your muscle, not the lifting weights. So people not optimizing recovery. So many studies on why recovery is important. So many things to improve your recovery. Number one, leafy greens. Number two, having a carbohydrate, quick digesting carbohydrate source such as dextrin, cyclic dextrin, whatever it is supplement wise that you're taking throughout the workout. So as you're breaking down your muscle glycogen, you're building it back up with carbs that you're ingesting on the spot. So work on that recovery and you'll see increased gains. The next thing I see that people don't really focus on is eating. Look, guys, as much as you want to deny it, anytime I see people on YouTube say, I can't get to so-and-so point or I can't gain weight to so-and-so point, it's literally not that you can't, it's you're not doing what you need to be doing to get there. So it's not that you are an alien and you are incapable of putting on the muscle and you've just tried everything and it doesn't work. I guarantee you, if you're not able to put on weight, it's something you're doing, not something that, you know, is a biological issue. You know, the fact that we need to feed and the fact that we have cellular processes indicate that you can gain or lose weight. You're not the exception. So if you're not eating enough, if you're not focused on your diet, do you not know your macronutrient totals? If you don't, then that would be the best place to start, because let me tell you from personal experience, I've spent over 12 years trying to gain weight and trying to figure it out, and I never once thought to eat because I'm special, okay? It took me that long to figure it out, but once I figured it out, I went overboard. I got up to 210 pounds, 210 from 160. That's gaining like 50 some odd pounds of weight, you know? That's incredible. And I did it all through dieting. It wasn't through anything special. I wasn't sleeping more. I wasn't doing this. I wasn't doing that. It was literally the fact that I figured out what I needed to grow and I started implementing it every day and I made it easy to do it. The next thing I want to talk to you about that goes along with that is preparation. A lot of people go to the gym, break down the muscle, come home, do nothing. They just do everything the same. It's almost no point in doing that because you're not going to get bigger, you're not going to get stronger, and at the end of the day, you're going to have a plateau that's going to be just there pretty much indefinitely until something changes, because your body can't keep progressing with no new materials, with no new stimulus, okay? So, you know, when you come home, the best thing to do is figure out how you can get on a system that will promote muscle gain even when you're not even thinking about it. So for me, what that looks like is when I go to the gym, I have the rice cooker on the counter, already got 2 scoops of rice in it, which would be several cups of rice, I think, once it's all cooked. I have it already loaded in there. All I have to do is add water and press the button, and I've got meals. Because I like my meals fresh. I have the hardest time eating out of Tupperware. My body literally won't let me eat out of Tupperware if the meal's cold, have no way of heating it up, so I have to have it fresh. So when I go to the gym, I make sure that when I come home, it is as effortless, it is as foolproof as possible. My protein shaker cup is sitting right here, the protein's on the counter, the rice is on the counter, the bag of chicken is out and thawing, everything is ready to go. There's no way I can fail. All I have to do is walk in the house, I see it, and I just execute. And that makes it easy. You know, if you're not preparing, then you're preparing to fail. you know, and well, I think the saying goes, if you're not preparing to succeed, you're preparing to fail. So preparation is everything. The next thing is not keeping track of your strength, not counting, you know, your maxes. And what I mean by that is I'm not talking about one rep max. I'm talking about your 8 rep max. I'm talking about your 5 rep max. I'm talking about reps, okay? So the biggest mistake I made was going into the gym, giving it everything I had, not keeping track. And then if you look back at my progress, I may have done 225 for reps of 8 on the bench for like 6 weeks straight. And I never thought to add maybe a 2.5 pound plate, right? Never thought to increase the work capacity or up the reps or up the sets or do a rest pause or any of that. I just went to the gym, did all that I could, which was 225 for 8. And then I would go home and then that was it. That was it. There's no increased overload. There's no new stimulus. So it's so easy to get caught in a rut. But the biggest thing with that is be intentional. You've got to be intentional. So if you're intentional, then you can start measuring these things. You can start documenting. You can be accurate with everything. And then with that accuracy and documentation comes pushing the letter ever so slightly to start gaining results. Maybe you could eat more carbs. Maybe you could up your protein. Maybe you could rest more. Maybe you could start taking a cyclic dextrin or a dextrose product, you know, during your workout to increase your recovery. Maybe try EAAs. Do something different, because if what you're doing right now is not working, it will not work in the future. Because what you're doing now is how you got to where you're at, and where you wanna go, you're gonna have to change what you're doing to get there, okay? So have an open mind. This video is all out of love. I know it was a little bit long, I always say that, but I am so proud and thankful for you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for comment, just content, just like this. Like it for the YouTube algorithm. Leave me some love. Go ahead and follow me on Instagram. I post there daily, just like on YouTube, Monday through Friday, so you can look forward to new content every day of the week then. Hope you guys have a wonderful day. Thank you for tuning in, and I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. Take care, guys.